Hi, this is Anna. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing great. And I was asked to show a tutorial on how I make these covers. So I make these covers this way only because I like the boxes and I want the boxes to be exposed like that so you can see, you know, the original box. If I was working with a box that's, let's say, not that pretty looking, like, you know, cake mix box or something like that, then I'll cover that with fabric or paper or something. But these, because I like these boxes so much because of the color, I figured a way to make these into journal covers. So I had two boxes, two different sizes, as you can see. If you watch my videos when I was showing these journals, they're actually pretty heavy, but they both have four signatures, and the width of the journal is the width of the box. So I'm going to make a tutorial to show you how I make these covers. Actually, I'm going to show you this cover because I have this box. So let me put this away. And so what you will need is a box of your choice that's something pretty looking, like, for example, this one. As I mentioned many times before, I just like it because of the colors. So this is going to be my front, this is going to be my back, but let's go to the list, through the list. So you will need a box. Then next thing is some adhesive glue, like this is what I'm using. Then next thing you'll need is I'm using masking tape. You will need good scissors, good cutting scissors, and paper, some type of cardstock paper, and also a trimmer, or you can just cut the paper with scissors if you want to. Then last thing you'll need is fabric. I'm using paintbrush for my glue, and whatever glue you use with fabric. So that, for me, this is what I use. So this box, I just noticed just now that it is, this is my front. This I want to be my front. So I have to open this side, and then this I will have to glue. The previous box, this was glued because I guess I opened this side. So this will have to be glued because this is our spine. So I'm going to open this side. And next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to cut this here and here. And this is pretty much how I did my Christmas journals, but then I covered that with fabric because those were fabric covered journals. So I'm cutting in the middle up till here. Maybe it will be better if I actually glued this first so it stays together. So Let's put some glue here. So you guys are not confused, and also so this is together. So I'm just going to glue this like it was originally glued. Next time I will know to open the other side. So I'm just going to hold it for a second because I don't know how to speed up the video. See, they use better glue than me. They have really good glue for these boxes. So just, you know, adhesive glue. that will hold it together. And then you're cutting the other side. Same way. This is why I'm saying you need good scissors that will actually cut this. And you go to the edge right here. I'm just trying to. Okay. And now you want to cut this part here, but this is pretty much already open to the end. So you have this flip here and here also. Actually, that was my next step, but I can do it right now. And the same on this side. You cut straight at the spine, but in a second we'll be trimming that at an angle. Let me see if this glue is holding. Okay. So this part, I really don't need this part here because I don't have it on this side, so it doesn't matter. But these are nice tabs for a journal. I'm going to keep these. So then these two, this is our spine. Okay, this is our spine. This is our book. So these sides here, I'm going to trim at an angle. This and this I already did. And then this one. And this one. And I just figured I would need one more thing here to help me hold things together. I'll be right back. So I'm going to either use these or paper clips. I'll see which one works. I'm not sure how you call these things. So, okay. So back to this project. These two I'm going to trim because I don't need these on the side here. And on these sides as well. So see what we did? We trimmed the corners here and here. And I could cut this off, but I don't want to because I am going to glue them down and these will give me a reinforcement to the cover. This isn't super thin, but this just gives me extra, and this is why I keep these here. And then this, let's see. I could probably trim these a little bit too. Tiny bit at an angle. Okay. And this side, see here I have this glue that will have to be here because I cannot remove this glue, but I do want to keep this flip. So probably could trim these sides a little bit too. Yeah, you definitely need new scissors to cut through this glue. Okay. So next part, we will be gluing this together. So I probably could do it like this and cover these versus doing these first and then this. Well, Maybe this will give me better look later on. So I'm gluing all of these flaps. Down. And this is why I need, let's see if paper clips work. Something to hold this down. Normally, I just put heavy books on top of that. But now, I'm not going to do that. So all of these, I'm gluing with the adhesive, good adhesive glue. And I'm not going to the very end because I don't want the glue to come out. It's not really very important to glue it to the end because this will be covered anyways. So see, if I use these, they would probably leave a mark. Yeah, they would leave a mark on the box. So I would need to use them with either fabric or something. And I'm going to do the same thing here. So whatever can hold this, and so you can see how the cover is coming together. Okay, and kind of want this to stick, and now the side. This right here. So you see the reinforcement on each side of the cover because I didn't remove these pieces here. So yeah, normally I put heavy books. And it really helps, but for the video, I cannot really do that. So I'm going to put this here. And the other side. Same thing. Okay. Oh, I could remove this. Okay, well, that wasn't really holding very well. So that's fine, because even better, because now this is flat completely. So you see, this is our cover pretty much. Now you see how it's made, how the box is glued together and cut, how the parts are cut. So this gives us very nice support for the sides. Okay. So next thing is going to be paper. I'm just going to make sure this is nicely glued. I just don't want marks from the paper clips on the cover, but when you do it at home, I would recommend just putting heavy books on top, and then you don't damage anything. So, a pretty cover, right? So next thing, we are adding paper on these two sides. So, I'm not sure which I want to use. This isn't going to be ice cream journal, it's just going to be regular eclectic, so I'm going to use this one. And I cannot show you the cover of this paper pad because I clearly used it. I used it for, I know what I used it for. For the binder journal, the mixed media project for somebody, the starter kit. So with the paper, you need to see how the pattern is going. Sometimes it really doesn't matter, so I cannot tell. Maybe like this. So you want to cover all that's here. So I kind of like the blue sticking out, so the blue would be fine. So somewhere here. And then I want to cover this whole thing. So I would go as far as somewhere here. So not necessarily to the end, because this doesn't matter. Not necessarily to the spine. So I'm going to get my paper trimmer. And I am cutting, which one was the height? That's important. So this is the height. Here's my height. That's my height and that's my width. Yeah, okay. So this is 8.4 inches. And this is 5, 6.5. 5, 6.5, so some more here. And these are my two pieces. So I'm going to glue these here. So this is width, this is height. So like this. Where's the front? Here's the front. Make sure you glue it correctly. And this is the back, maybe like this. Like this. Hard to tell how the pattern goes. I think like that. And then maybe like this. So now I'm gluing these two using my adhesive glue. And I covered that print. And this just has to get glued really, really nicely. You don't want any gaps on these three sides. And same on this side. I am not going with the glue to the very edge, as you can see, because I don't want the glue to go over the paper. same thing. You want this to be glued nicely. Here I see some glue came out, so I'm just going to roll it off. I'm checking the sides if it's glued nicely so it doesn't stick out. So now you see this is looking more and more like a cover. Takes a little time to make, you know, covers always take time. I mean, the inside takes time too, depending on how much you do. I think this is pretty good. Okay, so next thing is my masking tape, and I'm using it to cover these, make it more smooth, the edges here, but it also is going to reinforce our journal, our cover. So I'm just going a little bit over the spine, so maybe somewhere here. It doesn't have to be exact because it's going to be covered with fabric in a second. And the same on this side. That's enough for the tape. So you just want to make sure it's sticking nicely to the cover. And here. So that's our cover. And now we are going to cover this with fabrics. I just brought these fabrics here. I was showing these in one of my videos, I think Hobby Lobby. Oh, look at that. I didn't even see that. Oh, this is beautiful. Look at these colors. I was actually thinking of this one, but maybe this one is for the next journal. Oh, this would look pretty too. Oh, this would look pretty too. But I'm going to go with the this one. This one would look cool too. So I'm going to measure the fabric, how much I need for the spine. Let's see which way would this be tearing. Sometimes you have to see, because see how this isn't straight. So it's not straighter this way. Well, I'll try to tear it this way and let's see. So I'm going over further than the tape here. I'm going a little over just in case. Let's see if this is right. Yes, very nice. Okay. So I'm just going to pick the threads so they don't bother me. and I'm starting on the outside of the cover. So fabric glue, whatever you're using, and I like to use my paintbrush. Doesn't take much to make a mess. I just cleaned this space here so I can actually see. So you see, I go with the glue a little bit over the tape, and if the glue is beyond the fabric, then baby wipes can fix that. You can remove the extra glue with baby wipes. And I'll do the sides a little bit. Okay. And I just try to make it really straight. I think this is good. Okay. This would be somewhere here. I'm just cutting off the paper, the fabric that I don't need. And either like this or like that. Just make sure you don't have too much glue, but enough. And I'm going to go straight so the ends will meet. So I don't have to add trim. I really don't like to add trim to these particular covers because I think they're so pretty already that I don't need to add anything else to it. See, look at that. The lines, this fabric tore beautifully, so it doesn't happen always. So here is the spine, and here, and so now I'll just let it to dry, and then I can pick paper and make a hole for the tassel attachment and punch holes for the signatures. But this is the cover, so you wanted to see it. This is how I make it. Look how pretty this isn't this pretty, all these colors. I love these colors. So I'm not covering anything here because see some glue got on here. I can wipe it because it's all blue. The other journal had, see this journal, I left it like that too. This is the same cover, but this journal, this box had this print with nutrition and, you know, all the other things, so I covered that. because I didn't want this to be showing. I only wanted the blue color, just like this. So these journals are still available for sale at my Etsy shop. And this one I'll make, I don't know when, maybe I'll start working on it today since I already have the cover, but this has to dry. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you can make, you can find a pretty looking box and make it too. And this is really sturdy, really, really nice. So thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.